UV visible spectroscopy measures absorbance in the UV and visible light spectrum. The Beer-Lambert law relates absorbance to concentration. Lamax indicates maximum absorbance for quantification. Quartz cuvettes enhance accuracy due to UV transparency. Key components of a spectrophotometer include light sources, monochromators, and detectors. Building a calibration curve is essential for determining sample concentration, ensuring method validation in pharmaceutical quality. Here are frequently asked UV spectroscopy interview questions along with brief to the point answers tailored for pharma quality control QC or analytical RD interviews. Basic conceptual questions 1. What is UV visible spectroscopy? Answer. UV visible spectroscopy is an analytical technique used to measure the absorbance or transmittance of a substance in the ultraviolet 200-400 nanometers and visible 400-800 nanometers regions of the electromagnetic spectrum. 2. What is the principle of UV spectroscopy? Answer. It is based on the Beer-Lambert law, which states that the absorbance is directly proportional to the concentration of the substance and the path length of the sample cell. 3. State Beer-Lambert law. Answer. A is EXCXL, where A is absorbance, A is molar absorptivity, C is concentration, A mol / L, L is path length, CMA. 4. What is LMAX? Answer. LMAX is the wavelength at which a substance shows maximum absorbance. It is used for quantification. 5. Why is quartz used instead of glass cuvettes? Answer. Quartz is transparent in the UV range, while glass absorbs UV light and gives erroneous results. Instrumentation practical use 6. What are the main parts of a UV spectrophotometer? Answer. Light source, deuterium and tungsten lamp, monochromator, sample holder, detector and display system. What is the difference between single beam and double beam instruments? Answer. Single beam measures sample and blank separately. Double beam simultaneously measures sample and blank, reducing baseline drift. 8. What is the purpose of a monochromator? Answer. It isolates a specific wavelength from the full spectrum for measurement. 9. What type of detectors are used? Answer. Photodiode array PDA or photomultiplier tubes PMT. 10. What is baseline correction? Answer. It adjusts the spectrometer to zero absorbance with a blank, ensuring accurate reading. Method application 11. How do you determine the concentration of a sample using UV? Answer. By preparing a calibration curve, absorbance versus concentration, and using the sample's absorbance to find its concentration using the equation of the line. What are common applications of UV in pharma? Answer. Assay of drugs, dissolution testing, identity confirmation, impurity profiling, and content uniformity. 3. What is a calibration curve? Answer. A plot of known concentrations versus their absorbance, used to quantify unknown sample concentrations. Why is method validation important in UV? Answer. To ensure accuracy, precision, linearity, specificity, and robustness as per ICH-Q2-R1 guidelines. What is the acceptable limit for correlation coefficient R2 in linearity? Answer. Not less than 0.999 for quantitative methods. Troubleshooting quality control 16. Why might absorbance be negative? Answer. Due to improper blanking, dirty cuvettes, or instrument error sign. What causes baseline drift? Answer. Lamp instability, temperature changes, or instrument malfunction. E. What is stray light? Answer. Unwanted light reaching the detector, causing inaccuracy. It can be checked using filters, e.g. potassium chloride, PLATI. How often should UV instruments be calibrated? Answer. Monthly or as per SOP, using certified standards, e.g. holmium oxide filter for wavelength accuracy, 20. What is system suitability in UV? Answer. It ensures the system's performance before analysis, e.g. G. checking absorbance of standard at LMAX within acceptance criteria. Thank you so much for your attention. If you like these videos, please subscribe this channel.